All right, time to do this again. This time, do it right.
Miss Randall's landlady said she was seeing an older man.
Could have been. I wasn't privy to all the details of Julia's private life.
Uh-huh. Yeah, right, bitch.
Henry,
I got you on lock
now. People lie to me. She was seeing a man named Henderson. You know who I'm talking about.
Easy on, detective. I may have heard of Henderson, but I don't know his full name.
Uh-huh.
I think he's from New York or someplace back east.
Yeah, right, bitch. We got you dead to rights now. Another person said otherwise, bitch.
That's funny. Julia told her cleaning lady that he lived in San Francisco.
Okay, you got me. I don't know where he's from. Julia wanted money. She always wanted money. She thought she could get something from this guy.
She was wearing a distinctive engagement ring. You think she might have convinced him to buy it for her?
Maybe he did, yeah. Maybe he and Julia were getting serious.
Mm-hmm. A lot of maybes there, sir. A lot of maybes there, Henry. I don't like maybes.
How well did you know Julia Randall?
Vaguely. I'm in the clothing business, and Julia occasionally modeled for me.
I still don't know about this. What does Lie do again?
Come clean with us, Arnett. Was Miss Randall your mistress? Is that how she could afford such a lavish lifestyle?
That's a ridiculous
It's kind of contradictory
allegation.
To the other thing.
How could you possibly prove that I paid for Julia's things?
I can't. I don't think I can. But... I really don't think I can prove it, honestly. The most thing I could say is that this Mr. Henderson wears a similar jacket to you. But I don't think that'd be stretching it for the game, so.
Looks like I was mistaken.
Although he's really cocky now, I don't know. I hate when they do that, because it makes me think that, oh, maybe they are bullshitting in some way. But I really can't tell.
How well did you know Julia Randall?
Vaguely.
Hmm.
I'm in the clothing business, and Julia occasionally modeled for me.
One more time, I want to see
How
that.
How well did you know Julia Randall?
Vaguely. I'm in the clothing business, and Julia occasionally modeled for me.
Hold on, you can see his.
How well did you know Julia Randall?
Vaguely. I'm in the clothing.
That's really
business.
Weird.
Julia occasionally.
If you look at the mirror, if you look at the reflection from the window behind us, when he asks him that question, he's like giving us like a straight stare, I should say. And as soon as he answers, it's like all of a sudden his face is to like the left. It did not make any sense. But I don't know if that's like a clue. If that was just poor programming or whatever. Truth. Don't lie. So I think it would either be truth or doubt. That's the worst possible predicament to be in, a truth or doubt predicament. Because then you really don't know. What is the question about? Relationship of victim. Oh, okay.
How well did
we have
Julia
to keep listening to this, I'm sorry.
I'm in the clothing business, and Julia occasionally models.
So then why were you so concerned about coming to this? That would be my thing. But I don't know if that's what the game wants you to say. I don't know. Truth or doubt? Fucking truth or doubt? I don't know. I really don't. Oh my god. Do I do intuition or what? I mean, okay, one more time.
How well did you know Julia Randall?
Vaguely. I'm in the clothing business, and Julia occasionally models.
I feel like it wants us to do truth. I really do, but why do I get this gut feeling that Dao is somehow involved in all this? Fuck.
We were close. We were friends.
I have a feeling. God damn it, I shouldn't eat. That's what I was kind of avoiding doing just a little earlier, which is why I got a little quiet there. But I thought I was going to pull that shit off if I did doubt, so fuck. Damn it.
Ever heard of a Jimmy LeBlanc? No. Should I have?
Okay, he's totally bullshitting.
Is he an entertainer or something?
No, he's bullshitting for sure here.
I think you're lying. I think Randall was a high-priced hooker, and this Henderson character didn't want it to come out that he had been seeing her. I think he had LeBlanc and an accomplice bump her off. I think you know who Henderson is, and you're trying to conceal his identity. I think you've been out in the sun too long without your hat. Prove that I know who Henderson is.
Prove it, yeah, prove it. Back to this shit again. I think that just shows how guilty you are when you do that. In this game, anyway. I mean, fuck. Let's see. Like, prove it. Just prove it every time. Oh, God.
Sorry. My mistake.
Told doubt, 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 doubt.
So you wouldn't have any reason to believe that LeBlanc would be involved in Julie Randall's murder?
If this guy is a criminal, he might have been involved. But, like I said, I've never heard of this LeBlanc character.
That's total bullshit.
You told us that you were in fashion?
That's right.
The canary says he'll sing, but only if I guarantee he walks.
Some kind of traveling salesman?
Clothing emporium.
Once I got out of the Corps, I used my...
You were in the Marines?
Sure. I'm proud of it. Fighting 6th.
You were in the 6th Marines?
Yes. I was a captain.
Which company?
Various companies. We had a lot of casualties.
Which engagements?
Okinawa. A couple of other places.
That would be all for
Sounds
now.
Really fishy.
Very helpful.
I think Cole just realized something about him when he gave those answers.
That son of a bitch was never in the Marines. Why'd you let him off the hook?
Because we're giving him a couple of minutes before we start tailing him. Arnett is an amateur. We need to find out who killed the girl. Can you pass this on to Bukowski? Have him check the place out and go through his records.
Sure, I'll pass it on.
Thanks. Can you also have R&I run the records on a Jimmy LeBlanc and find out who was his last arresting officer? Have him get in touch via KGPL when they have some information.
Wait, where does Jimmy LeBlanc character suddenly come into this? I just realized. How did the question come to him? Or come
He's
about
in that
him?
Car at the lights.
Okay, cool. Hold on, let me just read that for a second. I'm kind of curious. Oh, I hope you can't hear that. You probably can. There's like a huge... I guess, airplane or... Or whatever. Off in the sky. Yeah, sorry about that. Anyway. Let's see. What did I want to look for again? Oh, yeah. Jimmy LeBlanc. LeBlanc. But yeah, I don't remember hearing about Jimmy LeBlanc. Whatever. Alright. Alright, let's do this shit.
He was squirming like a worm in there.
My
don't
best parts.
When they pull the war hero excuse? Actually, maybe you don't.
Well, this is not suspicious at all. Me just standing here in the middle of. Alright. Well, those guys look almost. Well, those guys are doing the identical thing. What the hell are they doing? Oh shit, we better go.
I'd have expected a cad like Arnett to be a better liar.
Oh, so he's a cadet? Or was a cadet? That's why he could pull off the lie so partially well. Come on, hurry up. Oh my god, so boring. Okay, so partner, what do you want to talk about? Let's just talk about shit. Oh, okay, here we go. God damn it, why'd he turn it right? What a scrub. Hey, look, a plane. I just had a plane over my house. Well, apartment.
Where are you taking us, Henry?
Let's see. Yeah, where is he taking us? I don't know, it could be quite a while. It's just gonna take forever, man. I mean, we only went through like two roads so far.
Can you quit
okay,
driving
three.
Like a jackass already?
Wait, what did we do? Really? Wow, we were too close all of a sudden? What did we do? We just turned the fucking... We just turned the other lane. It's not like, how the hell would he know we did that? It doesn't make any sense. I do that all the time. And no one busts me on it. What? Stupid game. Silly game and it's silly logic.
That idiot never stepped foot in Okinawa.
Oh, cool. Don't get so angry. Jesus. Yeah, I think this is more than a safe distance, honestly. Yeah, apparently I was attracting attention by driving recklessly. I'm guessing was the game's angle there, but I don't see how, honestly. Oh, I think he stopped. Yeah. Alright, let's see what this idiot does.
He needs money and fast.
No assumptions, Cole. Oh, okay, you're right.
Get in there and find out what he pawned. I'll stick with him, see how he intends to spend the money. Too much slack. Closer.
Puff it, Phelps.
Why don't I use the car? Why don't I just use the car? Let's just drive. Oh wow, you're stalling the fucking. That's funny. Alright. Okay, that's not really how I wanted. Okay. Go, idiot. I'm just having my newspaper, you know. Oh, look at that. Let's see. Oh, shit. Hey. You didn't see me. You didn't see me. Aha. Wait, is that him? I can't... Oh, where'd he go? Oh. This is not suspicious at all. Oh, my god. All right, use it. Move to the car. Go. Huh. Huff it and puff it. Oh shit! Don't see me. Aha. I moved out of the way. That's right. Nope, you didn't see me. How you think you could see me?
At risk losing the trail.
He's right there. I'm not losing anything. What are you talking about, stupid idiot? All right, let's go shine our shoes quickly. Quickly. Here we go. Somehow, us shining our shoes doesn't make him suspicious of seeing us. Oh, shit. Get out. He turned the corner. Go, idiot. Oh. Oh, does he know he's being followed?
That's right, Mexico City.
Oh, never mind.
One-way ticket, please. Next available seat.
That would be one day from now. Is that okay?
It's going to have to be. LAPD, the man who just came in here, he bought a ticket?
Yes, sir, to Mexico City, tomorrow night.
If you hear from him again, don't mention this conversation.
What have you got?
Cole.
He bought a ticket from Mexico City. Tomorrow night.
That's good. But this is better.
Oh, wow. You're actually going to show me for once? Wow, he actually did something.
God. It's Fabergé.
Roy.
Should have seen the look on the pawnbroker's face when I told him to hand it over. The guy who owned the joint thought it was worth at least 10 large for a cigarette case. Arnett only got 600 clams.
Wow. Oh, so he basically scammed him. Dearest Beverly, with love and affection, always. P. P? Yeah, I guess so. For a second, I thought I was going to, like, take out my notebook and ask him questions. I was going to ask my own partner questions. Then I started playing that, like, dramatic music, like,
go ahead, KGPL.
11K, go to Hollywood Station. Was that really what happened when you were over there? Well.
Roger, KGPL. 11K, en route.
Car 11K, Car 11 King, come in.
Car 11 King, go ahead.
We just talked to you. What do you get to do that for?
R&I reports the last arresting officer for DOA Jimmy LeBlanc was Patrolman Fred Wallace.
LeBlanc, actually.
On Hollywood 9th Beat, Sunset Boulevard between Gordon and Wilcox.
Car 11K, I don't know what that means.
Alright. Wow, no. Oh, wait, whoa, wait. Whoa, wow, we didn't have to use the phone. It just did it for us. What the hell? What was the point of that?
A one-way ticket to Mexico. Old Henry's looking as guilty as a dog next to a pile of dog shit.
What's his motive?
I can think of a few, but I'd put my money south of the belt. One guy plus two dames always equals problems.
Wait, what do we have, what are we doing at this police station again? Okay, yeah, that's probably useful to do first. You're gonna drive, you know, and I don't even wanna drive.
You're behind the wheel.
Yeah. Get behind the wheel, bitch.
Diseases be eradicated.
I noticed we didn't. I guess there wouldn't be any newspapers in this one, that's true.
Sir, I need the contraband list. Items stolen over the last year.
Hang on, I'll dig out a copy for you.
Hurry up.
Here you go.
Thanks.
Is the cigarette case on there?
Everyone's always pretty fast at what they're doing. Inspect recent... I'm sorry, what did you ask me? Fuck, what did you ask me, you idiot? Oh, cigarette case. Okay. I don't know. It depends. What the hell is the cigarette case called? I don't know what that means. Oh, wow, it's still a pillbox.
Seems Julia wasn't the first bored society girl to hide her bennies in that pillbox.
Mrs. Anthea Crawford. Gold emerald earrings. Black sapphire ring.
Julia Randall's ring. It's here.
Oh, and then the cigarette case.
It's here. Arnett must be out of his mind trying to move this while under a murder cloud.
Something else apparently. Gold candelabra. Billfold. Bond certificate, silverware, pearl ring?
Even the engagement ring was purloined. Arnett is a cad.
Okay, case cad means something I don't know. Oh, they weren't actually gonna. Oh, so that was. Wait a minute, but it said they had information pertaining to the case, but. And then I just go to the con. And then I just go to this guy and assume that it was a list that they compiled? Okay. Okay, whatever. I don't know how we jumped to that conclusion, but.
Like a swipe at me. Put him down with my sap.
Oh, is that what you're trying. Oh, okay. Is that a threat, huh? I don't think so. Ah, okay. Whatever. You're an idiot, though. I just owned you. Are we done here? Oh yeah, I guess we are. Okay, let's, should we go to the officer first, or should we do it to the residence? I guess we can go to the officer first, it's the first thing. I'm just gonna play it by the book here, whatever, fuck.
I could get discovered swanning around the nose.
How far away? it's not that far, but you know what? I'm gonna let you drive again. Here we go. Just hit the button.
You can drive.
Yeah, you can drive, bitch. Let's go. I can only talk so much, Ming. Oh. Oh wow, of course he's on a chaser now. Just ran him over.
Right behind you, Wallace, Detective Phelps.
Alright, Wallace, we got you.
Wallace, go left. I'm going damn right it after this little prick in the alley.
Okay, well, I'll go with my partner. Actually, I don't know why I'm going with you. I should let you do your own work. God damn it, I'm an idiot. Oh shit. So is it okay if I shoot him now? I don't know. Hey, why should you just turn double back with me? Oh shit, he just led us into an ambush. Wasn't that good though, because... Well, they fucking started shooting before they could even hit any of us. And I'm the headshot master. Holy shit, how many headshots can you take? I just finished you off with like a shot to the hand. What the fuck? Hey, ow, don't hit me. Hold on, don't hit me. Okay, alright. I just caught you in the head. This game's stupid. Are you kidding me? You guys are like fucking headshot masters or something. Or you take headshots like a fucking sponge. I swear to God. You bullet sponges. I'm sick of your bullshit. Not you, though. Unfortunately, you were the last one. Well, fortunately for
them. Outstanding warrant, armed robbery. Knocked over a drugstore back there, and it looks like he brought his whole posse with him. Bad luck for them.
They're all yours now. We need some information.
Ever heard of a burglar goes by the name of Jimmy LeBlanc?
Sure. Nabbed Jimmy on a burglary
sure, yeah.
A couple of years back. They cut through a music shop and into a jewelry store. He got 4 years. I miss his partner, though.
His partner?
Big guy. I had him cornered.
He didn't know his name.
He picked up this huge display case and threw it out a plate glass window. Then he vaulted out of there like something out of Barnum and Bailey.
Got away.
I would have had him, except for LeBlanc yelling, "Run for it, Willie."
And you think he was an acrobat of some sort?
More like a strongman, a wrestler, or a boxer, that kind of thing.
Thanks. You've been a big help.
You haven't done too badly yourself.
No, I guess not. We always do everyone's work for them.
You're suggesting LeBlanc is still working with Willie?
A strong man held down Randall while someone administered the morphine. Someone with muscle opened up LeBlanc's skull. Could be.
Wait, who the hell's hold on, I'm lost. Who's LeBlanc? If I've not been paying attention. LeBlanc's dead now? I'm confused. Oh, right, he's a burglar. Oh, right, okay, I remember. Cool. God. What the hell are you doing running, idiot? Oh, shit. New York. But we're not in New York. We're in L.A., so who gives a shit about that? I think I would... Oh, shit. I think I'd prefer if we were in New York. I hope one of the next L.A. Noirs is actually in New York. That'd be pretty cool. Obviously, it wouldn't be called L.A., but... You know, Noir. York Noir. New Noir. New York Noir. I don't know what they would call it, but I hope it's not LA again. It would be something else. Or if it is LA, it's like present time or some shit. Although I think I like this kind of like, you know, old setting for detective games, because, you know, it gives you more to kind of, well, it gives you less to work with, so it makes it like kind of more interesting and challenging, because you have to figure out more kind of, I guess, clever ways of figuring things out, because, you know, you don't have all that DNA stuff, like, every time. And that would get boring after a while. just getting picking up DNA and all that shit, all the futuristic stuff. I don't know. I feel like that this is actually better this way for a detective game. It would be kind of a little bit more annoying or boring if it was that futuristic stuff all the time.
House.
Eavesstrom Residence, 6:32 p.m. Pacific Standard Time.
LAPD, ma'am. Is Mrs. Eavesstrom in?
She is.
No. No, no, you don't come in here. I'm Consuela.
I am Mrs. Eavesstrom. How may I help you?
We appear to have recovered some
stolen
things
that belong
to you, ma'am.
Yes, of course. That terrible burglary. Would you like something to drink?
No, thank you, ma'am. We have some questions, if you don't mind.
Why would I mind, young man, if you are returning 43 pieces of my property?
Okay, before we get down to that, I'll have a scotch. Thanks, straight up.
Maria, can you get the detective a drink, please?
Nice. I do all the work again. I'm always one asking the questions. Apparently no one else is good at it.
Can you describe to us what was stolen?
It would be easier to describe what wasn't stolen, Detective.
Well, no, I'm pretty sure you have a lot more...
A priceless tiara that has been in the family for 50 years. A Fabergé cigarette case that was worth $25,000.
That's just two things. And also the second thing you seem really guilty about, so there you go. You're an idiot.
Why are you lying about the value of your jewelry, Mrs. Eavesstrom?
Who do you think you are, making heinous accusations in my own home?
Detective? It's kind of what I do. I make accusations a lot. Kind of an idiot like that, sometimes. Alright, train ticket. No, that wouldn't be it. What am I talking about? Oh, valued at... Oh, yeah, here we go. Here we go. Golden enamel Fabergé brand cigarette case valued at $10,000. And she said it was $25,000. But, and she said it was Fabergé, right? Yeah, Fabergé. She didn't say golden enamel, though, but I'm sure this is good enough.
We recovered the cigarette case from a pawnbroker. No one knows the real value of an item better than those guys.
I inflated its value for the insurance claim. There. Are you satisfied?
Insurance fraud or some shit. I don't know.
My daughter's boyfriend was quite taken with the case. I think he was even more disappointed than I was when it was stolen.
Who's your boyfriend? Wait, your boyfriend, right? I'm sorry. Oh, your daughter's boyfriend. Okay. I had a feeling... I forgot something there. Who's your daughter's boyfriend then, huh? Huh, Miss Eavesstrom? Mrs. Eavesstrom? I'm on to you, bitch.
What can you tell us about the burglary?
That terrible night. At least a year ago. But let's not go into that. Let's talk about what you've recovered.
You can see where your priorities are. Wow, but she gives a pretty straight face after that. Nah, it's definitely not truth, though. I can't buy that. Let's see.
I think you know more about this burglary than you were letting on, Mrs. Eavesstrom. There isn't an insurance claim involved, is there?
Are you accusing me of having my own home burgled? How dare you? What possible proof do you have for this scandalous remark?
Well, I do declare... Oh, yes, yes, I do declare, indeed, yes. Let's see. I don't have any evidence of that. Let's see. Testifies. No, none of this stuff fits that, so...
Sorry. Sometimes you have to
I'm doing doubt. I don't care. If I get it wrong, I don't care. Okay.
I get the sense that you're worried about something, Mrs. Eavesstrom.
I have already received the insurance claim, Detective. Is there any way we could keep the return of these items discreet?
Well, that just seems very suspicious.
That's about it for now, Mrs. Eavesstrom. The department will get in touch.
I don't know how that wasn't doubt, but okay.
You have I've only mentioned a few of the items that have been stolen, Detective.
No, you only mentioned
what
a few. You mentioned two.
What else has been recovered?
You see, Phelps, that's why you get the drinks in early.
Hello, Mother. Hello, detectives.
Hey. I didn't know your last name was Eavesstrom.
I'd like to ask exactly the same question.
You have met my daughter?
This morning at work. Oh, mother and father divorced. I took my father's name.
The detectives recovered
some of the
things
that were stolen by him. I didn't remember being Eavesstrom.
Well, what did you find?
A sapphire ring on the corpse of Julia Randall.
What are you talking about?
Your engagement ring, Miss Swanson. Would you be surprised to know that it was part of the proceeds of a burglary?
That's an outrageous allegation.
Yes, it is. I suggest we go straight
to
the
next place
and
sort
this mess out.
Stupid. Hey, look, we actually have someone in the back of our car for once. That's new. That's a new feature in this game. And it won't let me, it doesn't force me to pick a place. What the hell? It doesn't, like, pop it up for me, at least, like it usually does. Freaking DLCs. Hey, watch where you're driving, dick. Okay, I'm just gonna go on the right side for a second.
Something here.
Get out of my way.
Arnett is obviously arranging the burglaries.
That's my fiance you're making scurrilous accusations about.
I don't know if it's scurrilous, what the hell that means.
But neither of them are the type to creep apartments.
You're being ridiculous, both of you. There's a very good explanation for all of this.
What a sock in it, sister. You're being played for a patsy, and you're not even smart enough to see it.
Aw, Roy, don't be so mean. God. It's very mean of you, Roy. Alright. You gotta be nicer, man. You're a detective. Detectives are supposed to be nice. That is supposed to be like the little flower in the grass, you know? So gentle and moist and voluptuous, you know? Anyway. Yeah, Hollywoodland, that bullshit again. They couldn't just call it Hollywood, because apparently copyright or some bullshit like that. Oh no, you impersonating Hollywood, even though it's like in a video game and like it's pretty obvious that this isn't real. Like, what? I don't even get it. It's stupid. I really don't. This is so dumb. This whole thing is dumb. The way all that shit works is stupid. I'm out of here. I'm done with that shit. But yeah, oh look, it's getting really... Wow, that sun is bizarrely close, I have to say. Like, should it really be that close? It looks like it's gonna fucking supernova this whole place. Jesus Christ. Look at it. Oh shit. And I tried, jackass. Maybe I should turn my horn on. Totally unnecessary, but whatever. Yeah, I just beat shit up. But yeah, that fucking sun there, I mean, that looks, it looks fucking dangerously close, almost. Jesus. Kinda does. Oh, God. Oh, shit, I stopped paying attention. I was paying too much attention to the road to know where I was going. But yeah, LA. Oh my god, they're just gonna be stupid now. I better stop that. Yeah, LA, it's, I noticed those palm trees there. Well, you know what? Those palm trees are a lie, because LA is a lie, because LA sucks. That's right. Go to Miami, that's where you get the real palm trees. Even though it's also a sunny shithole. At least it rains there. And thunders. That's nice. Here it's just boring and dry and sunny. It sucks. Except for the night.
Come on,
sister. Oh wow.
Let's find out who your fiance really is.
Achievement unlocked. Huh. Chauffeur service. Escort Heather Swanson to Arnett's apartment without damaging your vehicle. Oh, wow. I'm fucking pro. That's amazing. In case I didn't show that, it said that I escorted Heather's Heather's. I had escorted Heather without damaging my vehicle at all, so.
Welcome,
clearly,
sir.
I'm amazing.
I'm sorry. Are you a resident?
No one can make. No one can freaking. Because of that achievement, no one can make the accusation that I'm a terrible driver now. So there you go.
LAPD detectives. We're here to speak to Henry Arnett.
Oh, Mr. Arnett? Apartment 30.
You seem very
you can take the lift.
About that.
Thank you.
He doesn't seem suspicious at all. Alright.
Well, isn't this just nice and awkward?
Oh. Why are we holding? Why do you need a holder? It's fine. Just relax. Oh my. Of course, everything happens right on right on
stop.
Our watch.
Okay, Cole, this guy's our case.
Go on,
put
get
your
out,
hands
bro.
In the
why
air.
Why would I kill him? That would be very uncharacteristic of Cole, too. And the way he walks down stair ladder is just not normal. I'm sorry. Not even ladder, the stairs. That's what I said, right?
Don't make me chase you.
That did not make any sense. All right, balancing act.
Stop
don't worry, we're really good
we'll
at this.
Shoot.
Oh shit! Wow. Okay. Apparently, I need to be a little bit more careful. Whoops. There we go. Jesus. Wow. Do I never learn my lesson from those corners? Honestly. Wow. He got away.
Looks like he got you good, Phelps.
Yeah, he really packs a wallop.
Wait, did I beat him still?
How did I get back here?
Under your own steam, miraculously. He came in through the window, said hello, and then keeled over.
How was Arnett?
He's coming around, too. He's all hopped up. Good time to get some answers.
Wait, did...
You missing something, Henry?
Yeah, it's a different guy. Ooh. Take a look at that. Let's get the watch first.
Vacheron Constantine. That's an extremely expensive watch, Henry.
Wow, we saw that on the contraband list. I remember that.
From my parents.
Uh-huh. Yeah, whatever you say, buddy.
You told Heather you're honeymooning without her?
Mexico. Mexico City. Oh, it's time to talk. Alright. And it's nighttime now. Almost. Sweet. Perfect time. Alright, Mr. Jackass. Hold on, let me go get my...
Don't let me leave until we finish this, detective. So you'd best get on with it.
Hold on. I wanna first get my hat back. I wanna get my hat back.
Won't let me leave until we finish this, detective. So you'd best get on with it.
There we go. I don't know how you get off, but let me hold on. I just wanna get my hat back. No? Is it anywhere here? Oh, newspaper. Nope. Where's my hat? Hat? Are you there? No? Letters. Wow, all this extra design for nothing, huh? At least they put the work in. Hold on. Oh, I just had to cough. Jesus, what the fuck? Anyway. Guess I'm not getting my hat. Whatever. Alright, bitches, let's talk. How do you feel about this so far? Very
we
casual.
We know all about the jewelry ring. You and Randall and LeBlanc and Willie doing the legwork.
I'm in the fashion business.
keep that lie up, buddy. It'll serve you well.
You're lying, Henry.
How can you prove that I'm involved, detective?
Really? You know, give me those faces and keep up the lie there. Just cause she's there, huh? God damn it. All right, the Fabergé. Hold on, what did we say? What, the jewelry ring. Yeah, the black sapphire. But
you're off.
Hold on, I don't.
The hook, for now.
Well, don't we kind of have evidence? I don't know. I'm confused about this one. I'm confused about a lot of the ones in this one. Let's see, the contraband list. I mean, it was in there, wasn't it? But it doesn't necessarily prove him, his involvement. And then, but then we have the Fabergé cigarette case. But LeBlanc and Willie were the ones who committed that burglary, right? So,
it makes sense.
Because they were the ones who stole the cigarette case. And then he had it. I mean, you could ultimately fit it to that.
Looks like I made a mistake.
Is there another question I can ask? Really?
We know all about the jewelry ring. You and Randall and LeBlanc and Willie doing the legwork. I'm in the fashion business.
Yeah, whatever.
You're lying, Henry. How can you prove that I'm involved, detective?
Well, okay, the cigarette case. Come on, he said it. How can you prove him? He's involved? The cigarette case. The cigarette case. The cigarette case. The cigarette case. The fucking cigarette case.
Because you pawned a Fabergé cigarette case today for $600. A case that is on a list of stolen items.
That's right, idiot.
It was Julia's idea. Get a list of society parties and find out where and when and then have the guests burgle. Julia was desperate for money. No matter how much we made, she always wanted more.
She's getting visibly angry, but she's not even looking at him. What the
fuck? Why did Reed and the
normal
kill Julia Randall? I wanted to stop. To get out of that life. I was gonna marry Heather if she'd have it. Julia told the others that they were out. That she was going to create a new gang.
Wait, what? I'm sorry? Julia told the others that they were out. Who was out? So, who are the others? She told them that LeBlanc and the other douchebag were out?
You're lying, Arnett. You ordered them to kill her. It was made to look like suicide, and when the coroner saw through that, you knew it was time to run. I told you I was involved in the burglaries. I had nothing to do with Julia's death. Why would I need to run?
But wait, why would you need to run? You purchased a train ticket. I don't know. You ask me. You tell me. You did ask me. But you tell me. Like, you literally purchased a train ticket to Mexico City. You know I saw that.
So what the hell are you gonna give this?
What the hell are you doing giving me this bullshit, honestly? God damn, these planes. I didn't expect that. I didn't think about that. Alright. I told you. Could he have ordered it? I don't know. He went to go see me about it. He was very fishy about Mr. Henderson. Could he have been Mr. Henderson? I don't know. But he did purchase a train ticket. Why would he run? Well, you purchased a train ticket, buddy. You tell me. I don't know. But as for whether he staged it, we don't have any proof for that. So this is kind of weird, the way this is worded. I guess that's the point, but
You don't ask, you never find out.
Is there another question I can ask? Let's try this first.
Who is Henderson, and what is his involvement?
Tell them what you know, Henry. I'll stand by you if you'll only tell the truth.
There is no Henderson.
Okay, well, you're kind of fishy about that even. Let's see.
Tell me about your first burglary, and don't lie.
I can't remember. I don't keep a list of these things.
Can't remember your first burglary. Yeah, right, bitch. Don't even give me that shit.
Sorry. My mistake.
Really?
Give it up, Arnett. You're facing the gas chamber. Give the judge some reason to commute.
You still don't get it, do you? Julia entrapped everyone. She was so beautiful. So goddamn cool.
You just kind of said that in front of your wife there, but okay. Or fiance. Anyway, okay. Let's see. Motive for Randall Murray. Okay, so I think that was actually truth. But whatever, I'm not going to go back on that. But I think that was truth. And I kind of had a feeling. That's what I was going for, because I think he's Mr. Henderson, right? I think that's kind of what he was saying. But he just said it so suspiciously. I thought, because he was looking away and stuff, I thought. No, he must be, there must be some bullshit to that. There must be, like, doubt, and then I kind of fish it out of him. So, I figured it was more like he was telling me that there just was no Mr. Henderson.
He won't let me leave until we finish this, detective. So you'd best get on with it.
And I'd be like, no, bitch, it was you. And then he'd be like, okay, fine, yeah, it was me. But no, I guess that's not the way to go.
Why did Reed and LeBlanc kill Julia Randall?
I wanted to stop. Get out of that life.
Diversion. Diversion.
Julia told the others that they were out. That she was going to create a new gang.
Sounds like you're just making this up on the spot, honestly. Wait, hold on. Hold on. Really?
You wanted Julia Randall out of your life.
What could this possibly be?
Julia was our friend.
What the fuck could it possibly be?
Julia was his hump, sweetheart. They were the Bonnie and Clyde of society burglars. He met you and realized he didn't have to steal anymore. He could just mooch from you. He needed Julia out of the way.
Julia was insatiable.
That actually seemed pretty reasonable.
Not the least me. She was never going to go back to the poverty she came from. Wanted it to stop.
Aw, you're so full of shit.
Henry Arnett, you are under arrest for burglary.
Yeah,
and
bitch.
For the murder of Julia Randall.
Especially under arrest because you pissed me off.
Right? I'm not the guy you want. Go talk to the good doctor.
Oh, we will, knucklehead.
Was that something he was going to tell
Meanwhile,
me?
Meanwhile, we're fitting you for convict stripes.
If we got him on the question. I guess he told me anyway, so whatever. God damn, this is a long case. Or at least it feels long to me. What the fuck? Oh my god. Stoneman. Alright, let's go. Let's go investigate Dr. Stoneman. Oh my god, get out of my way. I don't care. You know what? You hit me, it's your fault. I don't fucking care right now. These are pissing me off.
I guess the wedding's off.
They only robbed her mother and killed her best friend. Cut the guy some slack.
So how does the doctor fit in?
That's what we're about to find out. Maybe we should ask him to give you a quick once-over. That meathead gave you one hell of a pasting.
I've had worse.
You should have seen yourself staggering back in there like a drunken sailor.
Next time you can take the runner, Roy.
I didn't box in the Marines, though, did I?
I should have never told you that.
Why, because now he's going to try to use it against you? Ah, forget it, Cole. He's a dummy. Roy couldn't fight Chatworth jack shit. Oh, shit. That's why he's too scared to fight you. I mean, seriously, every partner we've had gets his ass kicked. Oh, wait. Wow, it's not going to stop for us? Alright. Cool, I guess we just go straight in this time. That was gonna do a cutscene thing. It shows us come here, but whatever. I guess because we were already here, but you know. God damn that plane! I don't know if you can hear it, but I'm guessing you probably can when it's really quiet like this. The game. An apple a day keeps a doctor away. Maybe we should have ate some apples. Apples or testicles. It's a good substitute. Alright, let's go in.
Hang on a moment, sister. Tell him it's Henry Arnett. And tell him it's urgent.
I can't do that.
Tell him, or I'll charge you with obstruction of justice.
I'm pretty sure that won't stick. Oh well.
Doctor,
she's scared.
Afraid
she doesn't know.
Mr. Arnett is here to see you, and he says it's urgent.
Send him in.
I told you never to come. Tell us the truth, Doctor.
I'm so glad you came. Prison
really?
Would be better than insanity, and I'm already half insane with grief. Do you know that I loved her? I ruined my life for her, and yet I still love her.
Will you testify in court that Arnett and Randall did these robberies?
They organized the robberies. Julie would get the names of the guests attending my wife's parties.
Oh.
Didn't matter how much money I showered upon her, it was never enough. She never really cared for me.
Doctor, I'm afraid you're under arrest.
Uh-oh. What a bunch of balls for you, man.
You'll call Dr. Gerard. No. Please don't cry. I want to see no one. Not my wife, or my children, nor my friends. And I don't want a lawyer. Just lock me up and throw away the key.
Is that window open? Very interesting.
What have I done?
Nice.
Didn't see that coming.
Me neither. Why didn't you close the window if you didn't see it coming? Or if you did see it coming. Idiot. God, you're so stupid. You're a terrible cop. I mean, I saw it coming too, but you know. But you know, I'm rooting for the guy. If he wants to get out of this, he can. Oh shit.
Operator, message for KGPL.
Putting you through now.
I need an ambulance and the coroner. Immediately to the offices of Dr. Harold Stoneman, 1646 Ivor Street, Hollywood.
Yeah, he's dead.
En route, detective. You have a message.
You're not gonna ask me if he's dead
detective
or not? I thought that's what
you do. Detective Bukowski says the suspect is named Wilson Willie the Wolf Reed, former wrestler. Last known address is an apartment building at the corner of Hollywood and Vine.
Oh, is he?
Detective
oh,
Bukowski
the WWF isn't out yet.
On our way.
All right, the WWF doesn't exist yet.
Let's try and wrap this up then.
For lunch? Or, no, it's maybe past lunch. What, late night dinner? God, you sound really invested in this
that
case.
That old boy really fell for that broad. She was incredibly beautiful, boy.
Would
yeah,
that's an opinion.
Away for a woman? Life has a way of making you pay for your pride. Quite the romantic, Phelps. Stick with the percentages. Broken hearts are for chumps.
You're talking from experience.
I certainly am. Oh, I like women as much as the next guy. As long as they're in their place and doing what they're told.
No comment from Cole. All right, cool. Let's go. Alright, so we gotta go meet this freaking future WWF wrestler. Probably won't make it, it'll probably be like a jobber or something. Whatever, we'll see. Oh wow, it's not very far. Alright. Was even necessary, he could've just said a block away. Yeah, we're literally a block away. Just over here, you'll see us. Louis' apartment. 1 a.m. Pacific Standard Time.
He's around here somewhere. A big guy. Neighbors say he always wears basketball shoes and a cream jacket. And get this. Kids around here say he plays the harmonica.
Find a game well and have the commander set up a drag net.
That game well.
Area closed off. We'll take this out of the street.
Why do we fucking call it a game well? Why is Bukowski giving me that look?
A harmonica playing wrestler. That's a weird one. Think he knits as well?
Just keep your eyes open and your mouth shut. We don't want him to bolt on us.
Hold on. Hold on. I gotta talk to Bukowski. Bukowski, what was that? Why were you giving me those looks? Bukowski?
Help me out.
No, I don't care about you.
Son of a bitch is around here somewhere.
We Rusty, of course, you're again not doing anything.
I'll say hello to the skipper for you. For now, follow up on the narco angle.
Something narco angle. We're following up on the angle of this wrestler, idiot. God, you're so stupid. Why do you... You don't know what's going on. Oh, my God. I fucking hate you. Also, you didn't even go to a game well. You went to your own stupid police radio, which I don't understand why we can't do that to begin with. Whatever. What are we doing? Oh, right. I wasn't paying attention to that. I was just going this way.
Wilson,
I thought that was
Reed,
the way to go.
LAPD, give yourself up.
Oh, shit. Wow. Alright, chase him down. Oh, he went up here. Wow, he fast. He fast. Nigga. Damn. Let's see. Let's go. Alright, I'm gonna shoot you. Where are you? I'm gonna shoot you. Damn it. Hey, hold on. My ladder. Oh, you idiot. I have to go at your pace. God, I don't want to look at your ass. Ugh. Stupid partner. Get my partner. Oh, this is really embarrassing when your partner's actually ahead of you on the chase. God damn it. Are you fucking kidding me? Wow, this is a lot of stairs. How are we going up these so fast? Jesus Christ. I know I'm double stepping and all, but... Partner, get my way. Okay, there you go. Just slow it down, because I told you to. Good job. You know your place. You know your place when it comes to me. Let me guess, I'm gonna get sidestepped again.
He's gotta be around here somewhere.
Oh,
there we go. No place to go unless you grew wings. There he is.
He has a gun. Oh wow. Do we have to kill him? I'm gonna shot a shot. Oh. Watch, headshot, headshot, headshot. Oh, I shot his head off, and then I shot his head. Cool.
Son of a bitch really picked a spot for it up here, didn't he? Julia Randall's folks are flying in from New York tomorrow to claim the body. I saw her on the slab. So perfect. Looked like she was made of porcelain.
What's with everyone's fucking
really
fantasizing?
Made an impression on me.
Julia had that
really?
Impact on a lot of men.
Christ, it's cold. You guys did good work here today.
I don't know, I didn't think
Roy.
It was so great.
I think you should buy your brother officers a drink.
Yeah, Roy.
Do you now?
Idiot.
That's very generous of you, Lieutenant.
Roy, I'm watching you, Roy. You're not going to take over this department one day. I know you probably plan on it with your freaking bitterness, but that's not happening, buddy. Yay, 4 stars. I wonder if it would have been 3 if I got 10 out of 16, because I know I cheated on one question. But hey, you know... Probably not. I probably still would have been 4, because I'm amazing like that, but, you know. But, hey, you know, it wasn't, like, total... I mean, it wasn't, like, total cheating. Like, I figured it out on my own. I just needed another go. You know? Just second chance, you know? Sometimes we should get second chances, you know? We all deserve a second chance. The slightest trace of morphine at the crime scene would have put a smile on Crothers' face. But we did. We had morphine evidence, didn't we not? Was there we missed something there, didn't we? Because that's why it was still lighting up. But like the investigation music was gone, was it not? God damn it! You know, from now on, I'm gonna check my intuition points and make sure that make sure that I can't, like, click on all clues or something. I'll try to be more thorough about that. That's whatever, stupid. Because sometimes it does that. It doesn't cross it out, the location. But there literally is nothing left there. We saw that with the bar before, or a couple, like, that bar and, like, the fucking... Or, I don't know, we saw in a couple places, you know what I'm talking about. You remember. Yeah, whatever. Anyway, moving on. Is it gonna be a... It is.
We have to get off of this hill.
That's one of our 50 cal still firing, Cole. The 22nd are still fighting.
It's over, Cole. Looks like you're one of the lucky ones.
Goodbye to your friend Hank, Jack.
He was your friend too, Cole. Is this how you're going to leave him? Are you wounded?
Not a scratch, Kelso.
Well, get up and get out of that fucking hole. Find a stretcher while you're at it so we can get him out of here.
Who's the senior officer here?
I guess that's you, Cole.
You were up here all night?
Yes, sir.
And your command?
Gone, sir.
Sorry to hear that, son. God damn it, we have beaten these bastards back. It's the beginning of the end, and it was one here. You're a goddamn hero, son. What's your name?
Lieutenant Phelps, sir.
I'm recommending you for the Silver Star and promoting you to First Lieutenant.
So basically... Basically, you didn't die, so you get promoted. And a silver star. Alright, cool. Manifest destiny.
Earl Phelps, a shooting at the 111 Club, 6232 Hollywood Boulevard.
Sounds like a homicide beef.
Two of the dead guys caught in the crossfire were carrying army surplus morphine. Get over there before homicide tramples all over the place.
Well, why would they? It's a vice case, you said.
Judge in Pasadena took the big sleep yesterday. He had a personal stash of 20 cigarettes. Appears we didn't get all of it.
We never do. I realize in a lot of ways this...
Yeah, I'm thinking of moving
this, the same angle is being... The same angle is being played in the vice case. In the vice desk, sorry. You know, we got like, We got a sort of a continuing story here with the morphine homicide. It was a serial killer, but traffic, it was always different, right? I never really thought about it in the case of Vice, that it actually was kind of, in a way, it's kind of the same story. In a way, like, it all has to do with the morphine. But yeah, I guess that's more sort of external, though. The serial killer one was a lot more linked in, that this was kind of more loose, so yeah, whatever. Yeah. Anyway... I think that's gonna do it for me for today. So thank you for watching and stay tuned for more.
Strips off me at the grand jury.
And Cole Phelps.
Thrown out.
God
Cole,
damn it.
Cole Phelps. Oh.
I can't seem to put this morphine to sleep.
Cole Phelps
a
says goodbye.
Judge. It's not good. Everyone.